It's the only reason why everybody loves it so much right now.
Right, right.
You have your privacy. You have your, it's exciting, you know?
Sure, sure.
But that might all change. Everything changes so quickly sometimes.
Yeah, yeah.
It's hard to know anything for sure and what's to come.
Yeah. Well, there's also, you know, I mean, Facebook is, you know, tremendously popular, and I spend a fair bit of time there, and I generate a lot of my interviews from, you know, my so-called Facebook friends.
Mm-hmm.
And, however, you know, keep in mind, there's other people that are very hesitant of joining that because they feel that everything that they publish will be, you know, read by, you know, government eyes. And I just assume that anything I write there is public knowledge, and don't be surprised if, you know, I mean, if you say some stupid things, then, you know, I guess you got coming, you know, what you got coming, you know?
Well, that's a good point you make right there. I think that's what I'm trying to do in my own life, in my outward life, too. You know, you're just trying to be honorable about the things that you say and you do, and you always think before you write something, especially on the Internet, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And things like Facebook and Twitter and all these different resources that we're using, they are a must. We definitely need this. And I think the evolution of it becoming a public thing, like, you know, the everybody's problem on Facebook is they're afraid that Facebook is selling all of their information.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know, there you go. You know, you are, all of these things, they have this, I guess, a silver lining.
Hmm.
Or yeah, there's a hidden thing in there, you know, where, you know, it's not necessary. They're going to give you something, but they're also, you got to give something else to
right.
get that kind of thing, you know?
Gotcha.
So, me personally, like I say, my mom calls me Matthew, but I call myself Max Radico. And since I've started doing that, you know, I just use Facebook as simply a social media, as I'm sure you do too. And, you know, keeping connected with a few friends here and there. Because also, we need to introduce this into our real lives. That's the problem with being a truther, is you can't be a truther some of the time.
Mm, there you go. Yeah. Yeah, that's right. So all our, you know, distant family that, you know, we don't see very often, but their Facebook friends, they're, you know, I would like to think that they're learning something just through my posts and, you know, and through your posts and, you know, the activists on the Internet. I mean, that's very important, but we also need activists on the feed, on the ground as well.
Absolutely.
We need every kind of activist that there is, and we need to invent new ones as well, you know?
I think the most important part of activism, though, is the networking. I think it's exactly what you're doing, you know, making it available to bring people down to that show that might not get there on their own.
Mm.
You know, yeah, getting together, networking, and meet people. Don't just do it on Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
If you do it face-to-face,
mm-hmm.
you establish that connection. And then when you're on Facebook, you actually can get some work done.
Yeah.
There's a lot of work to be done,
yeah.
And basically it's just about giving support to those people who are getting the backlash when they finally choose to you know, lift the curtain and take away that cognitive dissonance.
Yeah, that's right. Well, Max Radico, we are getting fairly close to the top of the hour, which is when we're going to say goodbye. So I guess we should maybe start talking about shutting her down. So I'm going to ask you if you have any websites or shout-outs that you want to encourage listeners to visit, or you can say whatever you want to say for your final minute here.
Absolutely. You mentioned the protests at the Vancouver Olympics. My friend Kanaska, who also was out there when we were in studio with you guys on episode 152.
Okay.
She was there during that whole event. She's back now here in Ottawa. She's singing up a storm, doing a great job at the Umi Cafe.
Nice.
Her website is Kanaska. That's kanaska.webs.com, and she's trying to start up something sort of like the Agora there, you know,
yeah,
where
yeah.
a bunch of people come together and we write some stories and maybe some songs and stuff like that, and
nice.
Just try and pump it out, you know, more media, more alternatives.
Yeah.
We need diversification of this stuff, right? Also, I have a good friend here in Ottawa, Rick McLassnom. He's doing some great work with Solar IMG. He's been watching the solar flares. This is something that intrigues me greatly, but, you know, of course, just like 9/11, there's so much science behind it that you can just take what you can take
mm-hmm.
and then learn some more and then sit on it and learn some more. But what he's doing with his website, watching all that stuff, it's great. It's really intriguing, and who knows how much of an effect that might have. And, you know, if we're going to lose electricity, if we can know about it a few days ahead of time, then maybe we can avoid the riots at the grocery stores, right?
Yeah.
Also got my boy Frankie G.
Yeah, man. Hey, Frank, how you doing?
Frankie's doing fantastic, and he's in Hamilton. He's connected with quite a few other people there. He's the creator of that fantastic movie that called Waking Up Canada to the New World Order. It's on YouTube. You can watch it free.
There you go.
Got quite a bit of information in there. We love advancing on all this stuff. We did a great video in Winnipeg together, Frankie and I, where we visited the legislative building. Which,
yeah.
You know, what do we know for sure? We don't know that anything really bad went on there, but we know that there's some heavy mathematics going into
there's some peculiarities. Yeah, absolutely. My buddy, Dr. Joe Hawkins.
Yes.
He has a wealth of information on
it was
that.
Thanks to you, actually, that we met up with him in Winnipeg,
yeah,
Surrey,
yeah.
And it was great. And he's doing really great too. I'll definitely plug Joe.
Nice. Yeah, we don't talk too often, but when we do, man, it's like we're brothers, and we just we get on so well. It's a neat thing.
Joe, I got a big spot in my heart for Joe. He's one of the ones holding us all together, kind of thing, you know.
Yeah.
And freemanitoba.com.
Like, yes.
He's into this sovereignty stuff too.
Yes.
And freemanitoba.com.
Mm-hmm.
And it's somewhat like Facebook, and we're all sharing videos and stuff like that. And it's a great community. He's involved with the Peacemaker Society there too. And he was the one who started up Richard Gage, right? He's the one who
That's
told
right.
Richard Gage, you got to make a video here.
That's
he's,
right.
He's the one who did Blueprint for Truth.
Yep.
And big props to him.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. That was a huge moment in the Truth Movement, yeah.
Definitely, definitely.
Nice, nice.
And Frankie G and Ben of the Jones family and VJ Sharma BK in Toronto and all these guys whipping out some awesome tunes, some tracks that are just so truthy. People love it.
There you go.
Yeah, and Sonia there in Montreal, she's doing great. You know, I don't even need to plug her. Everybody knows where to find her. She gets so many views on YouTube. Hopefully
yeah.
people are listening to her and not just staring at her pretty face.
Yeah, yeah, she's a lot of fun. And what she says, I do consider, you know, quite closely.
Yeah.
So, smart girl.
Yeah.
Definitely. Very nice. Okay.
Well, it's been an honor. And I'll plug Grasshopper Media. It is
of
just
course.
Simply a blog, Grasshopper Media, all one word, blogspot.com. Mm-hmm.
And your YouTube channel is Find It Here First.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
And we're also on live stream and Twitter and all those
okay.
different
yep.
things. And always Find It Here First. And you can always email me, findithereFirst@gmail.com. If you ever have any questions about Grasshopper Media, I will always
contribute.
Answer the question
yep.
of whether you can use the logo. Yes. Use the logo. Steal it. Use it. I don't
yeah.
even care if you use it for something bad. Go right ahead. Bad news spreads faster.
Oh, man. Hey, this has been a lot of fun, and I appreciate you staying up past midnight in your neck of the woods. So thank you, Max, and I would love to do this again. And of course, anytime you get yourself on Vancouver Island, you're definitely welcome in studio. So,
well, I think we're planning a trip this summer.
Hey, all right.
So 2011 Grasshopper Media trip, and Bernice will be back on the roads. That's my camper.
Yeah, okay.
And we'll all hop inside her there, and... hopefully make some good videos.
Nice.
Maybe we'll even get a sponsor at some point and get some live stream videos going, because that's what we really need.
There you go. Neat.
Yeah. Thanks
okay,
a lot, Ray.
Neat.
You're great. And like I said, you know, thank you so much for the work that you do week
yeah.
after week.
Yeah.
I'll meet you in the middle, man.
There you go. Well, hey, I don't know what else I would do, and I have a feeling that that's you'd probably say the same thing. You know,
yeah.
You got a lot of love in the heart, and this is how we show it, I guess.
That's it.
Very cool, Max. Thank you for coming on.
Thank you very much for having me.
All right, buddy. Be well, and we'll talk soon. Good night, sir.
You too.
Okay, very nice. Max Radico, that was very exciting. Okay, so, you know, he's... Max is, you know, showing up at events and bringing the camera and, you know, doing interviews and just trying to get information out there. So check him out. Again, his YouTube channel is Find It Here First. Very nice. Okay, I have a couple audio clips I need to play for the station, so that's what we're going to do for the next moment, and I will be back very shortly with the Unbought and Unbossed show. Hey, very nice. Thanks to those sponsors, Hornby Island Painting and Conspiracy King. Right on, guys. Because we are a campus community radio station, and your funds literally keep us on the air. Very important. So... So to those of you that are members, thank you, and you understand what's going on. Those of you that aren't members, please consider making a donation to CHLY, and you don't have to wait for the fund drive either. Okay.